Hello, my name is Jesus Medina and I'm the creator of KO Method, which is a holistic approach to fitness and self-defense training. I'm also the owner of Seabreeze Fitness, which is located in Costa Mesa, California, so we're recording this. Today we're going to go ahead and cover a little bit of light sparring. What I mean by that is the hitting is going to be about 20%, no more than 20%. Alright, we're going to be moving at 100%, footwork and all that, 100% evading, everything's 100% except for the punching. It's going to be light. Number one reason for now is because this is training. We don't need to put ourselves in a dangerous real rhythm of battle. We're going to put ourselves in the real rhythm of battle, but we're not going to have extreme danger, anywhere near danger. Why? Because we're only punching at 20%. And the real thing, trust me, you will hit properly. Alright, by you going slow and smooth with the punching, controlling those punches, going fast, right before you hit, snapping back so you don't hit hard, what do you think that is? It's straight up, it's control. What is control? That means you're good at your reflexes, know your body, you know your kinesthetic awareness, all kinds of stuff that really helps you. Time, engaging distance, dictating range, all that good stuff. That way it helps you in the long run, once you familiarize yourself with all that, to be efficient, alright? Not only that, but you'll be more proficient with your combination, unleashing your combination and stuff like that, and sticking with proficiency while you're doing all those high volume combinations. Anyhow, today I got here Warrior Steven. He's gonna help, he's gonna go ahead and spar with me a little bit. What else? So, normally we do full protective, meaning hand wraps and everything. Right now, all right, we've been working already almost 2 hours straight of pretty high intense conditioning that involves everything from myofunctional plyometrics to calisthenics to light weight resistance training, all of which is all explosive movements and stuff like that. All right, and we move and hardly ever break for almost 2 hours straight. So that's why we're a little bit tired now. We're gonna go ahead. It's already late, all right? So there's no need to put hand wraps on right now for the simple fact that we know for a fact we're not gonna be punching hard. If we're striking hard, if you're striking especially your back, yeah, you need to get some freaking hand wraps on at least, all right? So anyhow, just wanted to point that out. If you guys are gonna be hitting hard, freaking safety first, alright? It's better to be safe than sorry. Put those hand wraps on. And you shouldn't be hitting too hard anyways. It doesn't benefit you much. Not even your endurance. I know it sounds crazy, but it really, really doesn't, alright? Especially to your very well-conditioned fighters, alright? Striking hard, it really doesn't do anything for you. It really doesn't. Why? Because you're doing something that's so natural to you. Think about that, alright? Be more clear in the head so that you can really practice your skill and stuff like that. Form and all that. Now, if you're going hard, you don't have time to record proper form, even though you already know your form. Because once you go hard, form goes out the door. Most of it does. All right. So anyhow, we're gonna go ahead and get started. I got Warrior Steven here. We're gonna be punching at 20%. We're gonna be moving at 100%. All right. Here we go. All right. Extremely high volume punching. And mind you, he's not even a fighter, he's not even training to technically compete. He's just doing for the love of it. What it does to the brain, to the mind, that's how much out of it I am. Technically that's the same thing for overall. Brain is referring more to the muscle, mind is referring more to the conscious, but obviously conscious relies within the brain. But the point is he loves the challenge of connecting the brain, body, and spirit, warrior spirit at that, together. We got about 20 seconds left of a break. I'm pretty sure it's gonna be about a minute of a break, maybe a little less, but we don't wanna go any more than 1 minute. All right, so as you can see, what I was referring to about he's not even a fighter, look how much his output was, right? And I was testing him a lot, obviously. He was testing me a lot, and I like that. He was actually getting me pretty good sometimes. And if it was real, he would have hit me pretty damn good. Alright, I'm sure that at least three of those would have buckled me, given his size, alright? And even though he's, meaning tall-wise, length-wise, he has a lot of reach, and he actually knows how to use it properly, alright? Again, he's not an actual fighter, right? So, it's a lot of fun, and it's very, very beneficial, entirely from the inside out. So here we go, we're gonna do one more round. This time, elbows are included.